Hey y'all, it's your girl Sashi E. Welcome to my channel. No, your eyes are not deceiving you, y'all. These are my feet. I have very dry and crusty feet. And in today's video, I am going to show you guys how I take them from dry and crusty to absolutely soft and beautiful. Yeah guys, so when it comes to my skin is very dry. The only part of me that's oily is my face, so I do have to take extra precautions to stay moisturized. So in order to help me get the dry skin cells off my feet, I am going to be using two ingredients. I am going to be using apple cider vinegar as well as sea salt. Both ingredients have been proven to really aid with repairing dry and cracked feet. So I really like to use this on my feet because it really does make a difference and it really does help. Alright guys, so right now I am setting my timer. I did set it to 15 minutes, but if you guys need extra time, you can always add additional time. There are times when my feet really need some TLC and I'll just have my feet soaking for about 30 minutes. And I also wanted to tell you guys about this little spa set here. So I did purchase it from Amazon. It does bubble to give you that spa effect, but it doesn't necessarily make your water warmer. So if you add cold water to this, your water will remain cold. If you add warm water to it, it'll maintain the temperature. So that's something to keep in mind if you'd like to purchase this. So now I am going to be turning off my little spa set and I am going to be testing out my feet to see if they are ready. So how I'm going to do that is I'm just going to use my finger to see if the dead skin cells start to come up. If they start to come up, that's a clear sign that it is ready. As you guys can see, I am barely touching it, but it is coming up, so it is time. So here I am just trying to give you guys a better angle of my feet once I took it out of the pedicure spa. So as you guys can see, my feet definitely looks ready. It is time for me to scrub them. So what I'll be using to scrub my feet is my pedicure set. I got this from Amazon as well. As you guys can see, these are the same tools that they use at the salon. Alright guys, so now I am going in with my foot grater. So I love using this on my foot. This is what they use on me in the salon as well when I do get my nails done outside of my home. So yeah guys, I am going in with this and I'm just taking my time to remove all of that dead cells that you guys can see on the bottom of my foot. So I know a lot of people don't like to use the foot grater, so if this is too abrasive for you, you can always use a pumice stone. So I usually do this part of the routine with my feet still soaking in the pedicure spa, but because I am filming and I wanted to make sure you guys were able to see what I was doing, this is the reason why I'm sitting on my towel and doing this. But usually on a regular basis, I still keep my feet submerged in the water so that my feet can stay nice and moisturized, which makes it very easy for me to take off the dead skin cells. So if you guys do try this at home, I will suggest for you guys to keep your feet submerged and to work on your feet one at a time so that it can maintain the moisture. So I wanted to show you guys some of the dead skin cells that I was able to remove from the bottom of my feet. So now I am going to move on to clipping my nails, and I'm also going to be using the tools that you see right beside me to remove the dirt and debris that is located underneath my nails. Thank you. So now that I am done clipping my nails and so forth, I wanted to show you guys what I do in the shower. So I do use the pumice stone in the shower to kind of maintain the look of my feet. So I usually add some of my soap. This is the Dr. Bronner's peppermint soap, and I just go ahead and scrub my feet, you guys. If y'all are not washing y'all feet in the shower, definitely make sure you guys are doing that. I know some people don't even go down there. Make sure y'all are washing y'all feet. So as you guys can see, my feet are really nice and smooth. And now for the final reveal, y'all, I done went ahead and added me some lotion and some petroleum jelly to my feet, and baby, they look amazing. As you guys can see, they look smooth, they look soft, they look very moisturized. I did add me some nail polish and everything too. This is the lotion that I use, the Nivea lotion, and then this is the petroleum jelly that I use. I know a lot of people always say, oh, don't use petroleum jelly on your skin. When it comes to your feet, it's a must, especially if you have dry, cracked, flaky feet. Petroleum jelly is a must. There's something about it that makes it so effective and so efficient when it comes to keeping your feet nice and moisturized. So yeah, guys, that is it for today's video. If you enjoyed, please be sure to give me a thumbs up. Please be sure to leave me any comments that you guys would like. If you have any questions, just let me know down in the comment section. Don't forget to subscribe, turn on your notifications. I do post multiple times per week, so turn on that bell so you don't miss an upload from me. And I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye.